Aloha and mabuhay. My name is Emmie Ortega-Anderson, your host for Pinoy Power Hawaii. We want to thank ThinkTech Hawaii for giving us the opportunity to come to your homes every week live at 12 noon. Today is a very special program. It's an enlightening and empowering program with members of the Latter-day Saints Church. We're going to focus on genealogy, and our segment for today is called The Missing Link. It is a pleasure to introduce to you our three wonderful guests, servants of the Lord. We're going to start off with Brother Elder Walter Kawaiaiea, and he is the Family Search Specialist. Brother Kawaiaiea, welcome to Pinoy Power Hawaii.
Thank you. Aloha, Emmie. Good to be with you. It's always a pleasure to sit with you and to share some of the things that we're currently involved in, or at least I'm involved in. Mm-hmm. As most of people watching out there, I'm born and raised in Hawaii, local boy, lived here all my life, member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, currently serving a church service mission, mm-hmm. working at the Remote Operations Center located on Beckley Street in Kalihi at one of our church buildings, and excited about the work.
It's a pleasure to have you on board, Brother Walter Kawaiaiea. Next, we have Peggy Chee, Historical Records Specialist. Tell us a little bit about you, and welcome to Pinoy Power Hawaii.
Thank you for having me. I am born on Molokai, the island of Molokai. As a young woman, I was introduced into the genealogy records and fell in love with it. First time they asked me who my grandfather was, I said, "My tutu man, of course," not realizing there was a lot more to it. But over the past 50 years span of time, I've spent years and hours enjoying myself in the field and look forward to be able to share some of the information and experiences that I've had to be able to help others find their ancestors and care more lovingly for them.
Thank Wonderful.
You for Thank you.
50 years and you're only 35, yeah?
I know, it's a gift.
And that's the joy in serving the Lord.
Math is different on Molokai.
Molokai lanai too. Okay, next we have Sister Elizabeth Yuen, Honolulu Lead Rock. Welcome to Pinoy Power Hawaii.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here. I appreciate being here. I am Sister Elizabeth Yuen. I do serve a church service mission, and I am the lead for the Remote Operations Center. We have presently 17 church service missionaries that serve in this location. We are a direct support to Family Search, mm-hmm. and all of the different projects that helps to support the digitization of this. I was born and raised in Molokai up until 5 years old. Mm. Since then, I have been a resident of Oahu, and my career previously took me to California, but I have since retired and I serve my time with the Lord.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful. And you are the rock, Sister Elizabeth.
She is the rock.
I try.
Thank you. Genealogy is something that I've been asking Brother Walter for a long time. Please come and share, because I know the importance. To some of us, it is called the missing link, because some of us never have a chance to broaden or touch upon it. Tell us about the importance.
I couldn't help but laugh because you're looking directly at me and using the word missing link.
Yes.
Do I look like the missing link? Oh, never mind, Sister Chee. All of us have personal experience in genealogy work. I started doing my own family genealogy years ago when I first joined the church back in 1971. I was attending the University of Hawaii, mm-hmm. Majoring in Hawaiian studies, and had a project to go and interview all of the senior members of all sides of my family. Mm-hmm. And so I did, to complete the project. But what happened was life-changing, because I really realized that these were real people, and I share their DNA. So from that time on, I spent days and hours in the Hawaii State Archives, and a shout out to Adam Jensen, who we work with. Mm-hmm. And I just fell in love with connecting. And so in the world of genealogy today, for example, I think the buzzwords are connect and discovery. Mm-hmm. So many, we're all part of the human family. Everybody regardless of your ethnicity, your religious background, everybody wants to connect and they want to discover their ancestors. I mean, if you go online, you'll find so many websites that are all geared to family mm-hmm. search, family history. And of course, the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints has kind of been the forerunner. I mean, Family Search was formerly known as the Genealogical Society of Utah, which formulated 120 years ago. Mm-hmm. So they've, you know, they've been in the forefront in terms of preparing people, helping people to find their ancestors, coming up, you know, keeping up with the technology and the times. Mm-hmm. And so in the world that we live today, we've gone from microfiche, microfilm, mm-hmm. and today we're in the digitized world.
Yes.
And the good thing about digitization is that it makes these kinds of information mm-hmm. about one's ancestors available and accessible, as long as you have a smart device. Who doesn't have a smart device?
Yeah, that's the word. It's available, it's accessible. Mm-hmm. You know, in these days and time, there are a lot of sites out there, but they always want something, a fee, for you to access their records. In our records, it's available to all who ask for it.
Sure. I mean, at Family Search, and a lot of people, not just members of the church, but non-members, freely come to Family Search. There is no charge.
Mm-hmm. There's a app that's out now that's quite exciting. Mm-hmm. It's Family Tree that's put out by Family Search, and it's open to everyone. There's no fee. And I've worked in the past with the Boys and Girls Club of mm-hmm. EBBA, and we were showing them how to use it. And one of the most amazing things that they come across is as soon as you open the app and you log in appropriately, mm-hmm. you put your name in, many times names pop up. They populate your family tree mm-hmm. automatically because of the things that have already gone on before. And it's almost like your ancestors are there waiting to be found. And you get information that is already there. Mm-hmm. And it's shared openly. And there's a lot of different functions that it does. It has memories, it has pictures, it allows you to do so much. And it's free, and it's right out there in the front.
That is so awesome. It mm-hmm. brings me to the familiar phrase, knock and it shall be open unto yeah. you. And that's what you're doing, Sister Elizabeth, with the records and genealogy. So tell us what you've discovered.
There is the technical part of it. And looking at the remote operations center, we have missionaries that actually staff it. When you come to the center, and you're welcome to come and visit, we are there and we work with computers. So throughout the entire shift, mm-hmm. they are actually doing a lot of indexing mm-hmm. or putting together what would be projects so that it will be available, you know, for the indexers to index. Mm-hmm. And we also have three missionaries that are assigned to support and help the Hawaii State Archives. That has worked quite well. They do get involved with a lot of auditing of these records so that when it is published mm-hmm. worldwide, at least it is accurate and it will be for everyone to mm-hmm. view and to use also.
So these records are constantly being updated, correct?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the process, as Sister Yuen was describing, so you have these missionaries at the State Archives, for mm-hmm. example, and whatever the archivist there gives them using highly sophisticated image capturing equipment will capture the information on index cards of varying sorts, and that is uploaded onto the computer. The missionaries back at the center will extrapolate from that information the necessary genealogical mm-hmm. pieces, you know, name, place, date, that kind of thing. And it'll be uploaded eventually to Family Search, and that's what goes worldwide. Mm-hmm. So in the world that we live in today, you know, this whole process, so the remote operations center supports, you know, we're kind of like the feeder for Family Search when people
yes.
are looking for names. Mm-hmm. Like Sister Chi referred to the app. Mm-hmm. Like every week I get up, at least once or twice a week, I'll open up my app and there'll be new names that have just
pops up.
Like a magnet. They just pop up to mm-hmm. my tree and I'm like, I don't even know these people. Mm. But thanks to what the record remote operations center is doing globally mm-hmm. as the feeder of these names as their index and made available, So the whole process just makes things more accessible. Mm-hmm. It also helps to preserve original records. Mm-hmm. And so we're very much for that, because a lot of these records that some of them that these Sister Chi and Sister Yuen have seen go back to the 1800s. They're very fragile. So how do you preserve them forever? Mm-hmm. Digitizing them is one form of preserving it. If something, you know, should ever happen to it.
So this way we'll have it for future generations.
The key here is also to make it available. Yeah. The archives right now is really interested in letting people know that these records are there and they're available. Mm-hmm. So if you can't get to the archives, they have a whole bunch of information that's already been made available. And as it becomes available and it's indexed, it's added to the algorithm, and that's how you turn your thing on, mm-hmm. your app on, and there's all this information there. So it's a joint effort. There are other repositories that have signed contracts mm-hmm. with Family Search that will allow us to get an even broader spectrum for everyone to be able to find that missing link.
That's awesome. For somebody like me who would be coming in for the first time to use our facilities, I know it's user-friendly, mm-hmm. right? And you have the missionaries available to help. What could they expect when they first enter our doors?
There are two parts to the program. There is a family history program that we have, mm-hmm. and there is a family history center that serves the public and all of the members of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. The remote operations center are the busy bees. Mm-hmm. They do all the computer work. So we don't actually have patrons that come in that we talk to and work with. So it would be our family history centers, and they're located all over on every island. Mm-hmm. As long as you can find a stake center or you Google it, mm-hmm. you will be able to find the location, the phone number, and the address.
That is awesome. So I want to reiterate once again that these records are available not only for just members, but for the general
everyone.
Public.
Absolutely. Yeah, everyone. Absolutely. Absolutely. We have a lot of non-members, you know, just the general mm-hmm. public that will come in to use the Family History Center. Everyone's searching, and mm-hmm. it's basic. So you ask, you know, if you were to come in, how would you start? Well, you know, it starts with you, mm-hmm. and you just begin to start to identify, to build your tree, you know, just assuming someone is from scratch. And you identify, you know, mm-hmm. mom, dad, grandma, grandpa, both sides of the family, and you build your tree and you start to go back there, you acquire the necessary information, and you start to build and build that way.
Mm-hmm. So it has to start with me. I know that my ancestors are waiting for their records mm-hmm. to be started and to be open. I got to get the work done. And Brother Kay and I have had long discussions that, you know, when am I going to start? He started. He's way ahead. And in your search, Brother Kay, uh-huh. I know that I heard one time that you discovered that lineage that is part of the Hawaiian dynasty.
I had an ancestor during that time when I was at the archives, mm-hmm. you know, back in the 70s. Going through, and back in those days, you could actually call for the 1924 issue of the Advertiser. They'd bring it up. Mm-hmm. And I was looking through that one day, and I came across the Advertiser. So it was 1924, front page, second page, third page, mm-hmm. all in Hawaiian, which if anybody knows Hawaiian history, you know that that was a period of time. That was the generation of Hawaiians that were told, stop speaking Hawaiian, mm-hmm. begin learning to speak English. Mm-hmm. And there was no malice intended. It was trying to get the Hawaiians to learn another language. But in the process, they spoke English, and slowly the Hawaiians started to fade away. Anyway, so there it was. I had copies made, took it to Tutuka Venapukui. She translated it. Mm-hmm. What it turned out to be was my entire genealogy, tracing all the way back to this woman whose picture was in the article. She lived to be 101 years old. She was mm-hmm. born in 1823 in Avini, North Kohala. She was the great-granddaughter of the foster mother of Kamehameha the Great. And so in it contained her connection, her tie, mm-hmm. all the way back to that foster mother. And I was able to connect all the way from my generation back to this woman. She became my sixth great-great-grandmother. And so that was, you know, that was just an eye-opener for me. And once you experience something like mm-hmm. that, you can't stop. Mm-hmm. You can't stop.
It bites you.
Yeah, it bites you. So I'm coming to your house. You started.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Brother Kay. Thank you for sharing that very pertinent information. And we encourage you, our lawyer listeners, our viewers, to come on and visit us at the Stake Center and open up your genealogy. We're going to take a quick break, and we will be right back and again connect the missing link here on Pinoy Power Hawaii. We'll be right back.
Hey, aloha. My name is Andrew Lanning. I'm the host of Security Matters Hawaii, airing every Wednesday here on ThinkTech Hawaii, live from the studios. I'll bring you guests. I'll bring you information about the things in security that matter to keeping you safe, your coworkers safe, your family safe, to keep our community safe. We want to teach you about those things in our industry that, you know, may be a little outside of your experience. So please join me, because security matters. Aloha.
Aloha, I'm Yukari Kunisue, the host of Konnichiwa Hawaii, Japanese talk show on ThinkTech Hawaii. Konnichiwa Hawaii is all Japanese broadcast show, and it's streamed live on ThinkTech at 2 p.m. every other Monday. Thank you so much for watching our show. We look forward to seeing you then. I'm Yukari Kunisue. Mahalo.
Welcome back to Pinoy Power Hawaii, our second segment. We're going to go more into details about genealogy and the missing link. I want to thank again my guests, servants of the Lord, Brother Kay and Sister Elizabeth and Sister Peggy, for taking the time to stress and share the importance of genealogy. So we're going to go right back into it, because there are other pertinent discoveries and a search that you have discovered.
Well, you know, for me, I was just, when you mentioned the word discovery, to discover, I'm like, what does that actually mean to me? So I think back to that time that I, you know, I found this ancestor, and then from there, I just led to, you know, discovery of all and my ability to connect to all other people that were much closer to me in generation. Mm-hmm. And it made me realize that, you know, I need to learn about these people. Who are these people? Because I share their DNA. Mm-hmm. And perhaps, you know, part of why I am who I am is because of my connection to them. Mm-hmm. So that to me is part of the discovery. You really are identifying who you are. Mm-hmm. So that, you know, that goes far beyond just the vital statistical information of genealogy gathering, you know, place, born, date, that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. You really get to feel a sense of who you are.
Belonging.
And then perhaps it gives you a, you know, some sense of confidence. You know, sometimes you always tell, you know, you need to know, it's important for you to know who your family is. Mm-hmm. That's the reason why. It gives you, you know, you're not better than anyone else. You just know that this is your place. This is who you come from. Mm-hmm. And when you learn the people, your ancestors from the past, mm-hmm. you realize that, you know, you have a certain responsibility to behave
yes.
a certain way. You know, these are your ancestors. They're looking down upon mm-hmm. you, perhaps.
Yeah, so behave, Brother
Behave,
Kay.
I will, I promise.
But in your discovery, you learn that you are connected. We are connected in the bigger picture. So,
before,
Sister Peggy.
Before we got together, we did not know each other.
Uh-huh.
So one day, Sister Liz and I were sitting down, and we opened up the app, and we were playing with it, and we talked about, hey, remember that app? Let's take a look. A part mm-hmm. of it says, find a relative. And so we did. Mm-hmm. Tell them what happened.
Okay, tell us.
So what will happen is you go into the Family Tree app. Everybody needs to have that app on their phone.
Mm-hmm.
And when you go into it and you click, there's a feature, relatives nearby.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And when you go into that app, it will search and determine based on your genealogy and tree that you have in Family Search as to if there are people that are related to you that are using this app.
Mm-hmm.
And so what we found out is all three of us are related.
Mm.
Her name popped up. I said,
mm-hmm.
oh, we're related. I said, let's do him. And so he put me and said, oh my gosh, we're related to him. I think,
oh,
and
she
has it.
And this is why I'm sitting in the middle.
But you know, when I found that, the idea here is, okay, how are we related? What line is mm-hmm. it? And we all trace back to the Po'ohina line.
It's a common ancestral line that we connect
yes.
to. Yeah.
That's a common name.
Ohina is not.
It's not coming.
But more important.
Maybe I've been around Brother Cage too much.
That's probably, you know, that is. But in doing some research, we found that the Po'ohina line served under the royalty, under the ali'is. Mm. And I found that information while auditing some records at the archives. But the point here is that when we look for the missing link, we're usually looking far into the past. But it gives us the opportunity to see what's here before us right now. Mm-hmm. And somehow that's created a better bond, a more sacred bond, because we're looking for the same things. Mm-hmm. Mind you, in the 70s, mm-hmm. I was doing genealogy. And the way we did is you got the paper out and you wrote everybody's name. Mm-hmm. Hours and hours. And I mean literally hours. And then I would send it to Salt Lake and wait 6 to 9 months and hope everything was right. If I had an error, mm-hmm. when they sent it back, well, you got to make that correction and you send it back.
Now, and you wait again.
Yes, but now with the technology that's available, I can sit down, I can write a name, I can mm-hmm. send it in immediately. I will get an acceptance or a rejection.
And it's instantaneous.
It's everybody. Everybody mm-hmm. has this opportunity to have that.
The world of technology.
Right at your fingertips. Mm-hmm. And it allows us to find a broader base, both near and far, mm-hmm. both long ago and right now. Mm-hmm. And that's how we share what we have, and it grows that way.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to pick on Sister Elizabeth because she has Pinoy power connection. I'm wondering if our power connects. Yeah, wow. So I have yet to do my work because I like to think that I was related to your mom. Which became a very, very important companion, visiting teacher's companion for me. We've been a companion for many years. Yeah. So,
so perhaps if in another session we come on and you'll have the app, we'll get our phones. And
yeah,
we'll
I got to get started.
You got to get started. I'll get
we'll
you started.
Do that afterwards.
I'll see you at your holiday tonight. Uh-huh.
Yeah. So I realize now the importance because I know that I cannot wait for others to do the work. And a lot of us play the waiting game, hoping that a relative or somebody that we are related to will do the work for us. But it's probably not the case for me.
Well, and you know, you're not alone because there are a lot more people in your situation, but they're anxious. They want to find out. They mm-hmm. sincerely want. Mm-hmm. And this is, of any time in the world, this is probably the best time because mm-hmm. there's so much availability uh-huh. and accessibility due to the digitized world that we're now in. Mm-hmm. And it's really fun, you know. I mean, I was listening to Sister Chi talk about, I remember those days. And so, but you know, a credit to the old school way mm-hmm. of submitting, it causes, that's why if you go to the archives and you watch how she works, she's extremely patient. Mm-hmm. She's very diligent to be and very meticulously caring in terms of accuracy. Mm-hmm. Well, that lesson probably was learned in those days mm-hmm. when it takes you 6 months, you set them in, they send you back a error, and you got to hana ho and do it all over again. Those days don't exist anymore.
And the support, I have to tell you, she's sitting here quietly. Mm-hmm. This mm-hmm. woman is technically supportive way beyond what I can do. And she's just a technical giant for us mm-hmm. in our work, working with her, because she'll get you places.
Yeah, Sister Yuen is, she's the man. I mean, she's the rock.
She's the rock.
I used to say that to my granddaughter. But she is the rock. She literally
she is.
I mean, just her personality, her nature, uh-huh. she has no ill towards anyone. She's loving to everyone.
She doesn't make you feel stupid.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's important.
That is really important mm-hmm. because we're bringing things forward. Seriously, we're bringing forward very precious things. Mm-hmm. And that is and I'm just speaking from my experience.
Uh-huh.
I'm bringing forward my family.
Yes.
They're precious to me. Mm-hmm. And I want them to be treated properly. And so I'm on the computer trying to learn and thinking, oh, this is so wrong. And she would come over and she uh-huh. would make the corrections, never once making me feel inadequate. In fact, I could do all of that until mm-hmm. she walked away. Then I realized I couldn't.
Sister Yuen, let's hear from the rock.
I know. How did this get featured on me?
You're going to be at the rock. I'm going to be in the archives.
But what I would like to share is that there's many parts to the automation, mm-hmm. the digitization. And the part that maybe is not that known, because you'll find images, mm-hmm. and that is always readily available mm-hmm. in most of the sites that you would go into. Mm-hmm. So looking at the Remote Operations Center, we have one primary program, which is indexing. Mm-hmm. So think about it. You would see the image, but if you had a summary of what that image is, say it's a marriage record, would that not be easier to find what you need mm-hmm. in your research for your ancestors, where you have it right there and you can always look at the image? Mm-hmm. So what we do is mm-hmm. actually the indexing, which summarizes what that record is. And so it takes people to do that. Mm-hmm. It is opened up to the public. Anyone can register and do indexing. And we do have special projects specifically for certain areas where they can actually do specific records. For mm-hmm. example, Hawaii, and all that is being imaged and digitized from the Hawaii State Archives, it is now being indexed. So it takes about 6 months to a year mm-hmm. before you see anything that has been digitized, image mm-hmm. captured, and then released for the indexing that was done. Mm-hmm. What's really important to emphasize here is there's much time that is taken so that it is accurate. All the information will get done, it will be reviewed, mm-hmm. it will be proved, and for those records that may be difficult in mm-hmm. order to index or put into what would be a summary, it gets reviewed again mm-hmm. and again. And once it is determined mm-hmm. that everything has been checked, mm-hmm. then it gets released. And that adds to the time before okay. it gets released.
So I'm glad there is a check and balances system yes. in place so that you just can't go in and put every Tom, Dick, and Harry that you just wish to be in your genealogy.
I think the term we're looking for here is the source.
The source.
And that was never available before. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I could put down my uncle's grandfather's brother told me that this is who this is and that's how I know. Mm-hmm. And a second person would come across with some other information mm-hmm. that may not be the same. But having a source mm-hmm. is key now, and it's paramount in the work that we do to ensure the accuracy. Mm-hmm. And there's many steps, there's many ways we can go about doing that, but the work is awesome.
Well, there's a lot of work to be done, and our time has come up. We invite you to come back again, and we okay. can discuss more issues and pertinent information about genealogy. I want to personally thank you for taking your valuable time to come and share this very important information for all of us so we can get started and start on our genealogy, The Missing Link. My name is Emmie Ortega-Anderson, your host for Pinoy Power Hawaii, thanking each and every one of you for joining us for this very special segment, Genealogy and the Missing Link. Thank you, maraming salamat po, and mabuhay!